Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be showing you how I work on beads. Now what I've been doing, actually before I begin, I know this it's been a while since I've put up a post, so you know, sorry about the delay. But yeah, I think let me get back to what I was saying. Today I would be showing how I work on just plain round beads such as these, and I work them in a batch. I don't do them one by one. Now if you see, I have like I've used a mold, the jhumka mold over here, and I'm looking at roughly the 8 mm, the 7 to 8 mm size beads over here, which is used a lot in assembling a pendant. This one I just cut out. So what I just take a small quantity of a small ball of clay, and then I just keep doing this, put it in size 4, and you know, kind of work, and I just keep it. Don't worry about the shapes, because we are not looking at you know, the dome shape. We are all of these are going to be rolled into small beads like these. So I just wanted to show you that, you know, you don't have to do it one by one. Doing it this way would give you enough practice. Also, I think it'll increase the speed at which you work as you do it on a more regular basis. So I'm pretty sure your next question is, you know, going to be that, wouldn't these kind of dry out? Yes, that's a good question. And the answer is also that yes, it will tend to dry out, but there are ways you can actually help that process. What we'll do now is, once I've cut out the amount of clay that I had basically taken in my hand and made it into pieces, what I would usually do is I would just kind of touch it up with a little bit of water, just so that the clay remains moist. If you see, I'm kind of just moistening it, just so that, you know, because they're small bits of clay and they obviously will dry out quicker than bigger bits of clay. It's quite obvious. So what I would do is I would then, I usually work with, you know, at least somewhat cleaner hands, so that there's no dried bits of clay on my hands, so that when I'm rolling these beads, I don't want, again, dried bits sticking on. So I would just take this and give it a nice roll. And as you see, each time I'm going to be working on these beads, I know for a fact that the pace at which I am doing would increase. It's a good way to get roughly about, you know, 20, 30, or probably even more. Like easily there are about 30, 35 beads over here. So I would make beads like this. Just in places where I feel that it's getting a little too dry, I would just moisten my hand as well a bit. But at regular intervals, it'll be good for you to just you know, clean your palm, because any dried bits of clay, the disadvantage is that it just increases your work. You may not get well finished beads such as these. So if you see that in a short, I mean, I'm just, you know, in like a couple of minutes itself, basically less than 4 minutes, you know, we've kind of begun shaping our beads, and also, oops, sorry. So give it roughly about, I don't know, maybe about another 10 minutes or so, I would basically wrap up this whole thing. And then the next step obviously is the way I would kind of, you know, oil the refill, oil the back end of the refill. This is what I'm most comfortable using for even putting holes in beads. I would just do it this way. And the reason why I use this is just so that I get the hole straight through. So otherwise there's a good chance that there is, you know, it just does not come through straight. And I would just, you know, give it a nice gentle, you know, just to make sure that it is kind of, you know, in a good shape. So I just do it this way. It's a very quick process. Personally, I think, you know, just doing it on a regular basis gives you enough practice as well. And you get a good finished bead, a well finished bead. And that's precisely what we are looking for. And ideally, I wouldn't even do this right away. It's only for the video that I'm doing it. I would usually finish this entire batch and only then start, you know, giving the holes and all of that. So this is my method of working on beads. Just hope you know you find this method useful. Really, really basic. If you see that, you know, we have some, these are all pretty wet, so I don't want to really touch it and this thing. But all of these have a good 3mm size hole. They are roughly about 8mm in size, and they have like a 3mm, a 2.5-3mm size hole as well. So which is pretty good, and you know, you get very well finished off beads in this manner. And all of this is one batch. After this batch is done, I work on this kind of a batch. So if you are not confident of working at one go, you know, and making so many in one go, you can also take a smaller lump of clay, just maybe a small lemon size ball of clay, and then see how many beads come out of that, work on that, and get to, you know, you can at least work on something like that every day, and that helps you increase your pace, and you can time yourself. You'll realize that the number of beads that you actually get every day, if you keep practicing, is going to increase. So you know, that's actually which will obviously improve, you know, productivity ideally, because you know, beads can be a very, very monotonous task. So sitting and doing this at a stretch, it can be a little boring for a lot of people. So you know, this way what happens is, if you do it in batches, you can split your work, like, you know, do one batch of beads, then do something else, and then get back onto you know, working on beads. So maybe you can do like 2 or 3 batches in a day. You'll easily get 100 beads like this, and you wouldn't even get bored. You will, you know, it'll be rhythmic almost, and you'll start enjoying working on it, and obviously it'll give you good practice as well. So yeah, I really hope you like this method. It's quite basic, quite simple. You know, all we use is the knife, the refill, and this particular jhumka, this quilling mold, which, you know, is used for measuring the size. Nothing much. You know, have obviously clean hands, you know, a washcloth and some water just in case, and you're set to go. I mean, you know, that's it. So I really hope you like the video, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back to uploading more videos shortly. Thank you so much.